Welcome student, in this fourth revision video tutorial. In this video tutorial, we will revise update, delete and insert command of DML. So let's start it. Update command. It is a DML command used to modify the existing record or records in a table. How you use update command? Here this is the order how to write update command. Update table name, set column name, value, comma, then column name equal to values, so on, then where condition. Now in practice of update command, suppose you want to change the name of this city, Kolkata, to Mumbai. Then the question is, update the city name Kolkata to Mumbai of supplier code 103. Answer is, update supplier, set city equal to Mumbai, where S code equal to 103. One more example of update command. Suppose you want to increase 10% price of all Nestle products. Then the question is, update increment 10% price of all Nestle product. Answer is, update supplier, set price equal to price plus price into 0.10. where supplier name equal to Nestle. Now delete command. It is a DML command used to delete, remove or discard the existing records in a table. How you use delete command? This is the order of delete command. First write delete, then from, then table name, then where condition. Now example of delete command. Suppose you want to delete this second last record where code is 106. The question is, delete the record of supplier code 106. Answer is, delete from supplier where S code equal to 106. Again, I'm telling, don't write asterisk sign with delete. It gives error. And don't miss this where statement. Otherwise, all the record will be deleted. So be careful about this delete command. Now, insert command. It is used to insert, add or include one or multi rows in a existing table. How you use insert command to add single record? Syntax is, insert into table name values and then in bracket write value 1, value 2 separated by comma, so on up to number of columns in the table. Second way, you can add row with column name. That is, insert into table name, column name 1, column name 2, so on, then values, then in bracket values 1, value 2, so on. Third way, you can also change the order of column. Insert into table name, column name 2, column name 1, so on, values, then column 2, column 1, so on. But the number of columns should be equal to the number of values. Otherwise, it gives error. Here, value 2 associated with column name 2 and value 1 associated with column name 1. So on. Let's move to the examples. Suppose you want to add record with these values. Answer is, insert into supplier values and put this values. then table will be updated by this value. Another question. Suppose you want to add these values. Here city value is missing. So how you add this record? Answer is insert into supplier all the column names, then values. But here 109 is associated with column S code. Similarly, this toothpaste value is associated with this pname column. Now how you can use insert command to add multi row? Command is this way: insert into table name values, then first row value, second row value, so on. Here 11 means first row value of first column. Similarly, all values put in insert command. Now example: insert into supplier value, then first row value, second row value. Similarly, you can add many rows separated by comma. And then finally, the table updated with these two records. So here I completed all DML commands. I hope you understood all this topic. In case of any doubt, you inform me. I'll clear your doubt. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.